Good morning, dear children. All the living systems are made up of organic compounds. All the biological activities of the living organisms involve reactions of these organic compounds. Such organic compounds are termed as biomolecules. Today, we are going to start a new chapter named Biomolecules. In this chapter, we will discuss structures and functions of certain biomolecules like carbohydrate, proteins, nucleic acid, etc. So let's start. Biomolecules. What are biomolecules? Biomolecules are organic compounds which build up living organisms and are required for their growth and maintenance. Examples are carbohydrates, proteins, nucleic acid, enzymes, vitamins, etc. So biomolecules are organic compounds and they are required for the growth and maintenance of living organisms. In this chapter, you should learn about properties, structure and functions of these carbohydrates, proteins and nucleic acid. Let us learn about carbohydrate. Carbohydrates constitute one of the most important groups of natural products. These include compounds like sugar, starch, glycogen, cellulose, gums, etc. They serve as source of energy, for example, sugar, and also a store of energy, for example, starch and glycogen. Certain carbohydrates, for example, cellulose, support the plant tissues, while some others, for example chitin, form the major constituent of the shells of crabs. Earlier, these carbohydrates were defined as the hydrates of carbon and thus represented by the formula CxH2O Y. This was the earlier formula of carbohydrates. But later on, it was found that certain carbohydrates do not correspond to this formula. So nowadays, these carbohydrates are defined as optically active polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones or compounds which yield these on hydrolysis. They are optically active polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones. What does it mean, optically active? Optically active compounds means they rotate the plane of the plane polarized light either towards right or towards left. You have learned about these optically active compounds in our previous class. They are optically active polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones. Poly means many. Hydroxy group means OH groups. And the functional group present in this carbohydrate is either aldehydic group or ketonic group. That means carbohydrate in which OH group all either only OH group and at the functional group only aldehydic group by CHO അല്ലെങ്കിൽ കീറ്റോണിക് ഗ്രൂപ്പായോ സിഒയോ ആയിരിക്കും. Or cohorts which yield this zone hydrolysis. Or these carbohydrates yield these compounds on hydrolysis. So carbohydrates are optically active polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones or cohorts which yield these polyhydroxyaldehydes or ketones on hydrolysis. So on hydrolysis, these carbohydrates yield compounds containing aldehydic or ketonic group, polyhydroxy aldehydic or ketonic group. These carbohydrates are classified into three depending upon their behavior on hydrolysis. So depending upon their behavior on hydrolysis, these carbohydrates are classified into monosaccharides, oligosaccharides, and polysaccharides. What are monosaccharides? Monosaccharides are sugars which cannot be hydrolyzed into smaller molecules. Then oligosaccharides means they are carbohydrates which yield 2 to 10 monosaccharide molecules on hydrolysis. Adhaayathu monosaccharides nu parayna carbohydrate aanu, simplest carbohydrate aanu, adine iniyum namukku hydrolyze cheyan pattukku. Clear? Examples are glucose and fructose. On the other hand, these oligosaccharides yield 2 to 10 monosaccharide molecules on hydrolysis. They are oligosaccharides. Then polysaccharides means they are carbohydrates which yield large number of monosaccharide molecules or hydrolysis. So monosaccharides cannot be hydrolyzed into smaller molecules. Oligosaccharides give 2 to 10 small monosaccharide units on hydrolysis, and this polysaccharide gives large number of monosaccharide molecules or hydrolysis. These two carbohydrates, oligosaccharides and polysaccharides are deleted from this chapter. So in this chapter you need to learn about these monosaccharides only. Let us learn about monosaccharides. You have learned carbohydrates, its definition and classifications of carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are classified into three: monosaccharides, oligosaccharides and polysaccharides. The monosaccharides are the simplest carbohydrates which cannot be hydrolyzed into smaller molecules. There are two main classes of these monosaccharides. They are aldoses and ketoses. You have learned the definition of carbohydrates. What are carbohydrates? Carbohydrates are polyhydroxy aldehyde or polyhydroxy ketone. Monosaccharides are classified into two depending upon the functional group present in it. If the functional group of that carbohydrate is aldehyde, then that monosaccharide is known as aldose. The functional group present in carbohydrate is ketone, then that monosaccharide is ketosis. So aldoses contain aldehyde group and ketoses contain ketone group, that is CO group. Two examples for these monosaccharides are glucose and fructose. Both have molecular formula C6H12O6. The general formula of monosaccharide is CnH2n(ON), and glucose is formula is C6H12O6, and fructose also has same molecular formula, that is C6H12O6. Then the difference between these two, glucose and fructose, is in their structure. Both have same molecular formula, but their structure is different. What is that difference? Here you can see that this is the structure of glucose and this is the structure of fructose. The difference is in their functional group. In glucose, the functional group is CH, and in fructose, the functional group present is CU. If CHO is the functional group, then that monosaccharide is called aldose. So we can say that since here the group present is CHO, so this glucose is called an aldose sugar. In the case of fructose, here the functional group is CU. So this fructose is a ketose sugar. And in the same formula, different side of the functional group. Glucose is called aldose. Reason is, here the group present is aldehyde group. Aldehyde group is CHO. Aldehyde group is aldose. But here, in the case of fructose, the functional group is CO group. CO varumbol a sugar ne allengi aa monosaccharide ne parayna peraanu ketosis. Monosaccharides ellam sugars aanu. Okay, depending upon the number of carbon atoms present in a monosaccharides, this monosaccharides can also be classified into triose, tetrose, pentose, hexose, etc. അതിനകത്തെ കാർബൺ ആറ്റത്തിന്റെ എണ്ണത്തിനനുസരിച്ച് അതിനെ വീണ്ടും നമുക്ക് ക്ലാസിഫൈ ചെയ്യാം. ട്രയോസ്, ടെട്രോസ്, പെൻഡോസ്, ഹെക്സോസ് എക്സെട്ര. ഇഫ് ത്രീ കാർബൺ ആറ്റംസ് ആർ പ്രസന്റ്, ദെൻ ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് കോൾഡ് ട്രയോസ്. ഇഫ് സിക്സ് കാർബൺ ആറ്റംസ് ആർ പ്രസന്റ്, ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് കോൾഡ് ഹെക്സോസ്. ഹിയർ യു ക്യാൻ ഒബ്സർവ് ദാറ്റ് ഇൻ ദ കേസ് ഓഫ് ദിസ് ഗ്ലൂക്കോസ് ആൻഡ് ഇൻ ദ കേസ് ഓഫ് ഫ്രക്ടോസ്, the number of carbon atoms present here is 6 carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Here also 6 carbon atoms are present. So we can say that both this glucose and fructose are hexose sugar. Random hexose sugar. Adhuvala glucose nu parayunnathu aldose aanu, fructose nu parayunnathu ketose aanu. Why? Because in the case of glucose, the group is aldehyde group. In the case of fructose, the functional group present there is CO, that is ketonic group. So it is a ketose sugar. Then how to write the structure of this glucose and fructose? In the structure, both consist of 6 carbon atoms. In the case of glucose, 6 carbon atoms are present. Here also 6 carbon atoms are present. Both have same molecular formula also. Here in the case of glucose, the functional group is CH. First carbon atom, functional group present is CHO, and the last group is CH2OH in the case of glucose. First CHO you want, last CH2OH. In between this CHO and CH2OH, the groups are CHOH groups. Four CHOH groups are present in between CHO and CH2OH. CHO de CH2OH in the edicke 4 groups undu adu 4 CHOH aanu adine pratheyam endra chodicha third carbon le OH here this OH group is directing towards your left and in other groups this OH are directing towards your right side third carbon le OH matra left lotu aanu baaki moonu OH right lotu so first group is CHO and last group is CH2OH in between there are 4 CHOH groups and in the third carbon OH is directed towards left side and in other carbon this OH groups are directed towards your right side angle orthitna structure ilda nalukku in the case of fructose first group is CH2OH and last group also CH2OH and this functional group CO is present in second carbon second group is CO here also at third carbon this OH is directed towards your left side in the case of glucose also this OH is directed towards your left in fructose here also OH is directed towards left side and other 2 carbon atoms OH groups are directed towards your right side so ibide 6 carbon atom undu ibide first CH2OH group aanu last carbon le CH2OH first last CH2OH second carbon aanu functional group aanu CO then third carbon engane varum OH left side la fourth and fifth il OH right side undu angane orthirunna structure ivu varikkan irukku idu kaana odikkittu ee reethil orthirunna cheya so glucose is an aldose sugar and fructose is a keto sugar both are called hexose why because both consist of 6 carbon atoms so they are called hexose sugar on the basis of number of carbon atoms present in that monosaccharide clear you know that 2 common hexose sugars are glucose and fructose glucose is an aldose but fructose is a ketose why yes this glucose contains aldehyde group so this is an aldose sugar but fructose is a keto sugar because it contains ketone group both are hexose sugars why both contain 6 carbon atoms so they are hexose sugar but this is an aldose but fructose is a ketose this is the open structure of glucose it consists of 6 carbon atoms first group is CHO group and last group is CH2OH in between these 2 groups there are 4 CHOH group at the third carbon OH group is directed towards your left you know all these things about glucose this is the open chain structure of glucose this glucose forms a 6 membered ring form by the reaction between this aldehyde group and hydroxyl group at 5th carbon this OH group at 5th carbon reacts with this aldehyde group CHO and forms cyclic structure of glucose here this OH attaches to this first carbon and forms COOH clear and this oxygen links with the first carbon
and fifth carbon, that is this oxygen. First carbon and fifth carbon. This is the cyclic form of glucose. Fifth carbon le OH, first CHO group oda react edittu OH first carbon attach cheyyadana COH. Nittu ee O first carbon ilum fifth carbon kuda common aayittu link cheyyum. First carbon ilum fifth carbon ilum kuda common aayittu oxygen link cheyyum. Angane form cheyyunnathu cyclic form of glucose. Clear? Six-membered ring sugars are called pyranose because this name comes from pyran, that is a name of a six-membered cyclic ether. This cyclization results in the formation of two stereo isomeric structure of glucose known as alpha D glucose and beta D glucose. They differ only in the orientation of hydroxyl group, that is OH group, at the first carbon. So these two are the stereo isomeric form of the cyclic glucose. This is the Haworth projection for the cyclic forms. What are stereoisomers? Yes, stereoisomers have same molecular formula but differ only in the arrangement of atoms in space. Space or atom difference matre ullu, same molecular formula. These two are the stereoisomeric forms of the cyclic glucose. This is the Haworth projection. That means the simplest form of writing this cyclic form. First one is called alpha D glucose and the second isomer is beta D glucose. Here, this carbon is the first carbon. In alpha D glucose, this is the first carbon. First carbon consists of which group? CHOH group. So CHOH. Here this OH group is attached at the first carbon and it is below the ring. Clear? Then second carbon consists of CHOH. This is the second carbon. CHOH. Third carbon is COHH, COHH, and fourth group is CHOH, CHOH. Fifth carbon consists of CH, that is CH, and oxygen links with this fifth carbon and first carbon. This is the fifth carbon and this oxygen forms bond with this fifth carbon and first carbon. This is that bond. COC. COC. Clear? And sixth group is CH2OH. This is CH2OH. Fifth carbon CH, then this CH2OH, and at the fifth carbon it links with oxygen, this oxygen, and this oxygen also links with the first carbon, this. So total this consists of six carbon atoms and it is a six-membered ring. Total six carbon atom and six sides are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That means this is a six-membered ring structure. Then what is beta D glucose? The structure of beta D glucose is same as that of alpha D,
the only difference is the orientation of OH at the first carbon. Here, in alpha D glucose, OH group is attached below the ring, but in beta D glucose, it is above the ring. COHH. Here, CH bonds. That is the only difference between this alpha D glucose and beta D glucose. Second carbon, CHOH. Here also CHOH. Third carbon, COHH. Here also COHH. Fourth carbon, CHOH. Here also CHOH. Fifth, CH. Then at fifth carbon there is a CH2OH group. Here also CH2OH group. And this fifth carbon is attached to oxygen. Here also oxygen. And this oxygen is also attached to the first carbon. Here also it is attached to the first carbon. Clear? So it also forms a six-membered ring. So these two are stereoisomers. Same molecular formula, but only the arrangement of atoms in space are different. Clear? ഇത് വരയ്ക്കുന്നത് എങ്ങനെയാണെന്ന് വെച്ചാൽ ഫസ്റ്റ് ഒരു സിക്സ് മെമ്പേർഡ് റിംഗ് വരയ്ക്കുക. ഇവിടെ ഓക്സിജന് കൊടുക്കും. HOH. തേർഡ് കാർബൺ വരുമ്പോൾ നമുക്കറിയാം എപ്പോഴും തേർഡ് കാർബണയിൽ സെക്കൻഡ് കാർബണിനെക്കാട്ടിലും OHന്റെ ഓറിയന്റേഷൻ വ്യത്യാസം അത് കാണിക്കണം. ഇവിടെ HOH അകത്ത് എച്ച് മുകളിലോട്ടും OH താഴെയാണെങ്കിൽ ഇവിടെ വരുമ്പോൾ മാത്രം OH മുകളിലോട്ടും എച്ച് താഴെ. Fourth carbon, the same as the second carbon, CHOH. Fifth carbon contains CH group. This is CH group, and this fifth carbon is attached to a sixth carbon, CH2OH. This is that CH2OH group, and there is a link with the oxygen. This carbon is linked with oxygen. That is this oxygen. This also forms a bond with the first carbon. This is that COH. So this is a six-membered ring structure. Beta D varikkumbol idu maatram tirichu varikkum. OH mollottum H ne thaalottum varikkum. Baaki ellathinte orientation same aanu. HOH, OHH. Here also OHH. Then HOH. Here also HOH. Then CH. CH2OH, CH2OH എങ്ങനെ വന്നെന്ന് അറിയാമോ? C യിലെ ഇതാണ് ഫിഫ്ത് കാർബൺ, അതിൽ ഒരു CH2OH ഉണ്ട്. ഈ CH2OH അതാണ് ഫിഫ്ത് കാർബണെ അറ്റാച്ച് ചെയ്തേക്കുന്ന അടുത്ത ഒരു ഗ്രൂപ്പാണ് CH2OH. അതാണ് ഈ കാണിച്ചത്. ആ ഫിഫ്ത് കാർബൺ വേറെ ഏതിലോട്ട് ലിങ്ക് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്? ഓക്സിജനിലോട്ട് ലിങ്ക് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. ഈ ഓക്സിജൻ അതാണ് ഇത്. ഈ ഓക്സിജൻ തന്നെ കാർബണിലോട്ട് വന്നു. അതാണ് ഇത്. സെയിം ആണ് രണ്ട്. ഡിഫറൻസ് ഉള്ളത് ഒളി ഇൻ ദ ഓറിയന്റേഷൻ ഓഫ് OH group attached at the first carbon. Clear? Such a pair of stereoisomeric ring forms of any sugar differing in configuration only at carbon 1 are called anomers. So what are anomers? They are stereoisomeric ring form of any sugar differing in configuration only at carbon 1. Configuration means arrangement of atoms in space. Anomers nu parayunnathu stereoisomers aanu. Adonulla vyathasam nu parayunnathu first carbon illulla OH group inde orientation il maatrame vyathasam undu. Here this alpha D glucose and beta D glucose are anomers because they differ only in the configuration of OH group attached at the first carbon. Clear? The alpha D had a meaning in what? Here alpha kaanikkunnathu OH group engottu direct cheyunu adineyaanu alpha kondu udheshichathu. ഇവിടെ OH ഗ്രൂപ്പ് അറ്റാച്ച് ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്നത് ബിലോ ദ റിംഗ് ആണ്. അതാണ് ആൽഫ കാണിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നത്. ഇവിടെ ബീറ്റ ആണെങ്കിൽ എബോ റിംഗ് ആണ്. അതാണ് ബീറ്റ ഡി ഗ്ലൂക്കോസ്. ഡി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത് ഫിഫ്ത് കാർബണിലെ OH
ഇതിന്റെ ഓറിയന്റേഷൻ ആണ് ഫിഫ്ത് കാർബണിലെ OH റൈറ്റ് ലോട്ട് ആണ് ഇതാണ് തേർഡ് ആയി ഉള്ള ലെഫ്റ്റ് ലോട്ട് ഫിഫ്ത്തിലെ റൈറ്റ് ലോട്ട് ആണ് ഇതൊരു ആനോം ഇതൊരു സ്റ്റീരിയോ സെന്റർ ആണ് കൈറാൽ സെന്റർ ആണ് അതായത് കൈറാൽ കാർബൺ ആണ് അതിൽ അറ്റാച്ച് ചെയ്തിരിക്കുന്ന OH റൈറ്റ് ലോട്ട് ആണ് അതുകൊണ്ടാണ് ഡി കാണിക്കുന്നത് ഡി എന്ന് വന്നത് സോ ആൽഫ ഡി ഗ്ലൂക്കോസ് ആൻഡ് ബീറ്റ ഡി ഗ്ലൂക്കോസ് This glucose is dextrorotatorios. That means it rotates plane of the plane polarized light towards right. Clear? Next is the preparation of glucose. There are two methods for the preparation of glucose. First method is preparation from cane sugar, and second is from starch. Cane sugar is also known as sucrose. It is C12H22O11. When sucrose is boiled with dilute acids, glucose and fructose are obtained. Both have same molecular formula C6H12O6, and this reaction is known as inversion of cane sugar. So glucose is prepared by boiling sucrose with dilute acids like sulfuric acid. Then you will get glucose and fructose. Second method is from starch. Starch is C6H10O5N times. And on boiling starch with dilute sulfuric acid, that is H plus, at 393 Kelvin and 223 bar pressure, you will get glucose. Clear? So that's all for today. You should revise this topic and refer your textbook also. Thank you.